Duchene thrown right into the fire here. Top line center between Atkinson and Panarin. What do you guys make of this fit tonight? Torts going with the lineup right off the bat.
Might make you want to sign up there and play on that team. I mean, that's
the question is the guy on the left going to be there, right?
And that's the question for Duchene going forward. You know, they get this guy. He's not signed. They're hoping they can sign him, but Panarin's probably leaving. Bobrovsky's leaving. So does Duchene really want to stay? I guess I'm putting the cart before the horse. There's still a lot of hockey left, but that's just something I've been thinking about. But that's a great lineup. I mean, Atkinson's got speed. Panarin's creative. Duchene has speed. This could be a dominating line. I really like that line. I like Pierre-Luc Dubois, what he's done in that first line position. But he's going to look back really good between Foligno, Josh Anderson. That's a big, heavy line. You like that going to the playoffs. So I like the way they have their first line and second line set up here right now. And we'll see what happens. I mean, does Panarin stay? You know, I've talked about this before. I think they got to get something for him. They can't just let him walk. But I think they almost have two windows here to win the Cup. All in this year, if they lose Panarin, Bobrovsky, and if they can sign Duchene, they still have lots of money to go after other free agents to keep this ball rolling with a relatively very young Columbus Blue Jacket team and have a crack at it maybe in 2 years.
Skill needs skill. You got to put skill guys with skill guys. No use putting a hammer with a tuning fork. It just doesn't make any sense. And coaches still try that. I like the fact that all three of the guys playing together are very skilled. They're very fast. They got good vision. They're good passers. They can put the puck in the net. It's going to be a very tough line to play against. You mentioned Atkinson. He's got the speed. He's got the grit. The other guys can make plays happen on the perimeter, and they're all very fast. I like this lineup. I think it's going to be adequate defensively. It's never going to be great defensively, but again, that's part of the thing you have to give up as a coach is good defense in order to give them the freedom to do things offensively. I've always liked the character of Columbus. I've always liked the grit of Columbus. You mentioned Josh Anderson. I think he's fantastic. Boone Jenner. They're a very tough team to play against when they're rocking and rolling. They got a big defense that can join the rush. And Bobrovsky, when he's hot, is as good as anybody in the NHL. So you look at this team right now on paper, and we haven't seen them play a game yet. They look as good as just about everybody that's in the playoffs right now. Tampa Bay looks a little bit better. Maybe Winnipeg looks a little bit better. But they can match up with just about anybody else in the NHL.
You said you saw the scenario play out in juniors from a guy as far as leaving his team that day and going to the team that he's facing that night. Is that a good thing for a player? Obviously, travel-wise, it's easier. But mentally, when you're really not detaching yourself from that situation, he made that same drive today from his house. He's in the same barn, yet he's wearing the different sweater that night. What is that like from a player's mentality?
It's funny. Scott and I were just talking about that out in the hallway, that maybe it's good it happens right away. It happens that day. You don't have 3 weeks to worry about, geez, we're going back home. We're going back home. You know, don't go to the game, honey. They're going to boo me when I'm there. When you're talking to your wife, things like that. So I think it is good. They're playing each other quick. They got the hugs away at the start of the game. They all came in. They met in the hallway.
They may boo him tonight if he scores, though.
Well, he's hoping they boo him.
Yeah, everyone, that's a good thing.
Everyone's hoping that he's booed in every building that he goes to the rest of this year. So that's a good sign for Columbus. So I think it is good. I agree with Scotty. Get it over with. Get this part of the thing done and get focusing on the Columbus Blue Jackets making the playoffs and winning the Stanley Cup.
Plus, I mean, it's a good game for him to get his feet wet going against his old teammates. Ottawa's not that great defensively. They're not in the playoff picture. They're selling. But I think it's going to be awkward for both sides. I think it would be tougher 2-3 months down the road. You face your old team, especially for that one lone player. It's always harder on the guy that got traded. Everybody else, those guys are still there as a group knit together. But I think it's a little awkward for both sides so quickly seeing a guy that just played with him not 2 nights ago.
Yeah.
Very awkward, but I think it's the way to get it done and get it over with personally.
We said second trade in the NHL and the second time that this guy has to face his former team the very first game. Last time traded from Avalanche to Sens, and they faced each other overseas.
It's crazy to explain trading in the NHL because this is a good young player, a high draft pick, third overall, and he's already been traded twice, and his numbers are good.
Yeah.
His numbers in the NHL are good. They're not like he's going there and stinking a joint out. He's putting up good numbers, and yet he has still been traded twice. So it's just crazy.
He's in high demand.
Maybe he'll get a no trade in his next deal.
he's going to
be a free agent.
He can't give the 10 teams. He's got to go with all the teams,
right? Yeah, I think he's going to get. Yeah.